Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about reflections. Reflections off your room boundary surfaces, your floor, your ceiling, your sidewalls, your front and your rear of the room are very, very critical because that contains room sound. And our goal, obviously, when we're doing games or vocals or music or whatever our usage of the room is to add just enough of the room sound to achieve the desired effect in our mix. Now, maybe we want no room sound. Well, that's a possibility, and that's why we sit near field, because the closer you sit to the speakers, the more of the room sound you take out. But we really have three reflections from the sidewalls that we need to be concerned with. There's a primary reflection, which is that reflection that's closest to the sidewall. That strikes that sidewall and comes back to the listening position. And then when it strikes that sidewall, it goes across the room to the other sidewall and then comes back to the listening position. That's the secondary reflection. Then there's a tertiary or third reflection that strikes the sidewall, hits the other sidewall, and then comes back and hits the first strike wall. And those three are very critical, especially in the lateral domain. You have to be able to control those and minimize their impact on the direct sound. And like I said, that's the reason people sit near field, because it helps minimize the room sound. But managing reflections is very, very critical. You have to be able to hear everything in the mix. You have to be able to hear what's going on with your product that you're producing. You have to be able to hear all the sounds that are in there. And there are certain sounds at certain frequencies that your room will not allow you to hear if the reflection level is interfering with the direct sound from your speakers. So there's a real easy way to treat reflections, and that's through the process of absorption. Absorption is a common term. It's converting acoustical energy, airborne acoustical energy, into heat, causing the process of absorption to occur and losing energy that way. So you can minimize the impact of reflections through absorption. One of the greatest ways or easiest ways to use absorption is to use acoustical foam. Acoustical foam is open-celled acoustical foam. It has a lot of absorption. You can choose your rates and levels of absorption. It's easy to install, and it's quite painless. And you don't need to build anything. You don't need to have carpentry skills or shop skills. You can simply install the foam in the correct locations. Finding those locations is critical. You need to treat the area on the sidewall, starting behind the speaker, and then also behind the listening position. About 1 to 2 feet is a good start and end point. Start 2 feet behind the front speakers, and about 2 foot behind the listening position, and treat the whole side wall. Not just parts, but the whole side wall. Try that for a while. See how it works. It might be too much. It might be not enough. But it's a tuning process, and you're trying to dial in that correct balance between reflected sound and direct sound. And there is no textbook defined ratio of time signatures on direct and reflected sound. There's windows that people shoot for. Some use below 20 milliseconds. They want those sidewall reflections to be 20 milliseconds or less compared to the direct. Some choose 15. I've been in some rooms where it's 10. So it all depends on your personal taste. Sure, you can measure for this. A lot of people don't have the measurement equipment to do that. You can simply do it with your ears, and you can do it with tuning. And using open-celled acoustical foam, it's easy because the pieces are easy to move around.